thanks for coming to Nutritional Truth. My name is Pedro and we are here to talk about water again. Around 60 to 70% of our body is water. The question for today is, when was the last time your doctor talked to you about water? Doctors, most of them, they don't understand anything about water. What they think is that you just need to drink plenty of it to be healthy. I said 60 to 70% of our weight on the scale is water. What we have more in our bodies is water. And nobody gives value to that. Almost nobody studies it. And that's what we're gonna talk in the next couple of minutes. For your curiosity, Alex Carroll, that won the Medicine Nobel Prize in 1912, while studying, he took a chicken's heart from the chicken and he put it to work on its own with proper machinery, of course, and that heart was beating for 27 years without stopping. Now, have you seen a chicken living for 27 years? Of course not, but how does that heart was working for 27 years? The answer to that is because every day they would change the liquid that fed the heart, and then he proved to the world that who determines the cellular age is the environment where the cell is living. If you have your cells in a bad environment and you start feeling sick and unwell, it doesn't make any sense to give medicine to it. Let's give an example. If you have a sick fish, the first thing you do, of course, is to change the water where the fish is, and then you treat the fish. It doesn't matter what medicine you give to the fish, if you keep it in the same dirty water, he will always be sick. How would you have an healthy fish in a sick water? Do you think the fish will survive? Of course not, but how will I have an healthy cell in a sick blood? And now it's time for you to ask, is the water that I'm drinking pure? And I answered to that question in my previous video. You can have a click here to watch it again. What is important in water? First of all is the pH. Children's are alkaline. Old people are acid. As long as you get older, your body will get more acid. If you wanna get young, you'll need to alkalinize. Cancer builds up in an acid environment. If your organism is alkaline, cancer cannot grow. Cancer cannot grow in an alkaline environment. For the cancer to evolve, it needs acidity. The pH of our blood is between 7.35 and 7.45. This is our body pH. Now, I want you to get the water that you're drinking at home, take the label and see what's the pH on it. Most of them are less than 6. So, when you take a water that has a pH below your blood pH, you'll have to put your body to work just to balance the values. Not just for you to have an idea, a soft drink has a pH of around 2.5. A children that takes one glass of soft drink, she needs to take at least 32 glasses of good water just to repair the damage of that glass of soft drink. Now, if you let soft drinks get into your house, you don't like your children. You're gonna apologize me for saying this, but you really don't like your children. They don't go well in school, they get sick, they get fat, they get everything else, and you don't know why. Of course, by letting children drink poison, we could not expect anything else. The quantity of people getting sick because of soft drinks is unbelievable. You start using a water with 10 of pH and you see how your health will change. Now the first days is not gonna be good, you're gonna have headaches, you're gonna feel bad, and that's because you're gonna have something that is called detox or a healing crisis. But the pH only solves one problem in the water. There's other problems, and another one is the redox. The water can be oxidant or antioxidant. You can measure the ORP of the water with equipment like this. Let me tell you something. If you have a reverse osmosis filter at home, throw it away today. Reverse osmosis is water that is dead. You shouldn't drink that. That water is used for pharmaceuticals to dilute medicine. Reverse osmosis takes all the minerals away from the water. It's like distilled water. She loses conductibility. One of the functions of the water in our bodies is to conduct electrical signals. There is no way you're gonna live healthy drinking an oxidant water and not an antioxidant water. You should measure the ORP and determine if the water is oxidant or not. The conductibility of the water. The water has to conduct energy throughout the body. If I'm going to raise my hand here, I release an order from my brain and the water has to conduct the signal throughout the body. If the water is distilled or from reverse osmosis, you don't have that conductibility. You're gonna be slow. The superficial tension of the water. There is a time when the water has to go down throughout the body, getting down and down. But there is a time when the water has to come up against gravity. And if the water has a high surface tension, the water doesn't come up that easily. It means that the water doesn't go to places properly. All of those parts that the water doesn't go properly remain dehydrated. The lower the surface tension, the better, and I talk about that in my previous video. You can have a click here to watch it now. I hope that after this video there will be no soft drinks, no more sodas, no juices in your house for your family and for your children. Because after knowing this, if you still are using soft drinks and juices and sodas, you are declaring that you don't like them. Thank you for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe so you can stay updated with the latest nutritional truths.